Bushenyi in western Uganda seems a perfect place for dairy farming. It has the right climate and large grazing fields that are lush for the better part of the year. Traditionally, the lives of people here have revolved around rearing Ankole cattle. But times are changing. Many farmers are moving to commercial agriculture, with an increasing number looking to dairy farming. The farmers typically cross their indigenous cattle to high-yielding, exotic European and North American dairy breeds. But for most of these farmers, the high milk yields they expected, up to 30 liters per cow, have been elusive. The problem of low milk yields has defied many previous attempts to fix it, greatly frustrating farmers' ambitions, as one of them here narrates.
mukagenderera umuntu ogo wa hansi ngwe muryo mutoreko kutarari sente nitungu tuka tunga mate mingi twaza guma tugereza binyansi byonka twaza kugereza kikwenda ngo tunga matago kureba ngo twagiye kitwaganyurwamo.
We expected to tell us which kind of animals she'd be keeping, so from here we zero to what, for example in Butere here, which will be the best animals that farmers should go in for.
Kitu mbaya saiti ni kukosa ndume. Hapo nyuma ilikuwa heai, ilikuwa natembea. Na walikuwa nakuja na mambo hiyo yao. Na tulikuwa napata ndama mzuri sana.
The farmers didn't know exactly the dairy cattle breeds that they have. Neither were they comfortable with the services that were being provided in terms of breeding services and the type of marketing services that were available.
Work of the 4-year Dairy Genetics East Africa DGEA project investigated this problem of low milk yields by crossbred dairy cows.
What we hoped to achieve by implementing the project was to find out whether our objectives were real, that is, could we provide farmers with well-documented evidence to show exactly what breed they have and how best they suit their conditions, and also influence the other actors to put in place or to come up with models to deliver those breeds to the farmers effectively.
The process of identifying the right breeds required that a large number of farmers be enlisted for the study. As a result, 1,100 households were recruited at different project sites in Kenya and Uganda. A total of 2,500 cows from these households were evaluated for productivity for a period of 2.5 years. Additionally, state-of-the-art genomic technology was used to determine the breed composition of the cows.
What farmers knew they had was slightly different from what they really had.
In addition, every 2 months, a group of enumerators recorded the husbandry practices, socio-economic conditions, and animals' performances on each farm.
We broke into countries, Kenya and Uganda, so we were able to look at the difference, at the difference between those two countries and farming systems. We looked as well broadly at the cost of production for those kinds of systems, and understanding better farmers' characteristics in this area.
Many Kenyan and Ugandan farmers who participated in this study wanted to know why their animals were not producing as much milk as expected. The biggest finding of this study was that the average milk yield was just 5 liters per cow per day. And the milk yield of the highest grade animals, those that were almost pure exotic, was not significantly higher than that of the cross breeds, only half exotic. It shows there is little advantage for smallholders to upgrade their animals' stock to the highest levels if they cannot, in addition, provide the good feeding and management practices required by exotic animals bred to produce the greatest amount of milk. The study showed that many adult cows have small body frames and low body weights, characteristics typical of stunting, which could be a result of poor feeding. The study also found that the process of continuous but unrecorded upgrading and crossbreeding in this region has made it impossible for farmers to know the breed composition of their cows. Now that the participating farmers are armed with the knowledge of the exact breed composition of their cows and how they perform, they can now make more informed breeding decisions.
Before getting into touch with the ILRI project, I didn't know that there is another type of, or another good breed of cow. But when we get into connection, I understood that there is the Asha, there is the many types of breed.
With the information I've got, I'm going to change because I know where to start from. I know what to start with. I know what to have, when and how. I know the right part to play.
This project brought many of the dairy industry stakeholders together. They identified priorities and developed strategies that give farmers access to appropriate breeding stock. Transforming this region's ubiquitous smallholder dairy farming into viable commercial enterprises will help many families move out of poverty. Although much remains to be done to give many more farmers across the region access to the right dairy animals, the new knowledge generated by this project lays the foundation for building a thriving commercial dairy sector in East Africa.